Welcome to the Uncommon Transformation Television Series.
Akwa Ibom, ay ay ay, si nene bara suene ki song emananye, Akwa Ibom oji, ay ay.
You are welcome to Akwa Ibom State, the land of uncommon transformation. Come and join us, live amongst us, and invest, and you will not regret. I welcome you.
The building I just came up from looks like any other one, doesn't it? But trust me, it is from here, from this little corner of the ultra-modern government house complex known as the Hilltop Mansion, that Her Excellency Ekaette Unoma Akpabio, the governor's wife, works her thoughts that dovetail into those lovely programs for the women, the widows, the children, and the less privileged in the society. The result of which is joy, happiness, excitement for the woman they've come to know as Mother Teresa. I'm sure you're curious to find out what she has been up to recently. Okay, come with me. Let's go on a voyage of discovery. Come.
Loving our neighbors as ourselves, as enunciated by the Holy Scriptures, entails compulsorily spreading love and joy to all peoples at all times and in all circumstances, without any form of discrimination and of prejudice to their circumstances of life, color, or creed, whatsoever, howsoever, and wherever we may find ourselves. The wife of the governor of Akwa Ibom State, Mrs. Unoma Ekaette Akpabio, being a virtuous woman, fearfully and wonderfully made in God's own image, is attempting to live out this commandment in obedience to her Creator. Thus, she has dedicated her life to the service of God and humanity, spreading joy and love by bringing succour to widows and other less privileged members of society through her acts of benevolence.
You are the one that shows mercy to the widows. I'm a widow, and if you saw where I lived, you will weep for me. I'm a widow without an inheritance from my husband. I pray that God should bless you and your family.
I want to thank God for the life of our widow and her children. And I want to say that may God continue to bless her and bless the work of her hands. May God continue to bless the children and shield them from the eyes of the evil one. All this we ask through Christ our Lord. On behalf of Family Life Enhancement Initiative, I want to commission this lovely home in the name of God the Father, Amen. God the Son, Amen. And God the Holy Spirit.
Her support for multiple birth programs has been phenomenal. Being a twin child herself, she is not unfamiliar with the challenges that are associated with multiple births. This invariably moved her to support multiple birth parents, not only morally but also financially. This does not include many others she has assisted in paying school fees and medical bills. Some she has even flown abroad for surgery for cases that cannot be handled locally. Her benevolence in this direction and to widows will no doubt come under the klieg lights at the International Conference for Widows to be held in the state later this month.
As a mother, I know how children feel, especially when they're deprived. And then as a young woman, I knew how it was with my mother, who was a widow. And then when I married my husband and I met his mother, she told me a few stories. So that equally informed my decision on what to do for my women and for the children and for the vulnerable. You see, a lot of us don't always think about them, especially when God has placed us in certain positions of authority. We tend to look at the people that are very comfortable and they have not. What happens to them?
Being herself a twin, she understands what it means to be a mother with two or three children. So she started this program to help those women. She does it every 3 months to help mothers. She sends her people, they go around hospitals to check mothers with multiple births. And once every 3 months, she gathers them out and helps them with some amount of money so that they can use to start trading and take care of the children.
Whatever she's doing is from the heart. So that's why she's been able to reach out to these women.
Her Excellency's supportive role to her husband, the governor, has aided his actualizing the vision of making Akwa Ibom a destination of choice. While the governor has instituted an infrastructure renaissance via many turnkey projects like roads, airport, an e-library, flyovers and bridges, power, and many more, Madam has been investing heavily in human resources through her numerous education programs to orphans and the less privileged children. Her empowerment initiatives for widows and women generally have been phenomenal and on a steady rise. It is also to her credit that women in appointive and elective positions in the state have surpassed the 35% affirmative action. Her Excellency's good works and efforts at providing succour to the poor and needy have not gone unnoticed. Central Bank of Nigeria, CBN, commended Madam's role in promoting micro-enterprise development and her passion in going the extra mile to put smiles on the faces of the most vulnerable people in the society. The Apex Bank made the observation and commendation through the bank's Assistant Director, Development and Finance, Babatunde Ogunlaja, during project's inspection tours and verification. The Bankers Bank further commended Madam for using a non-governmental platform to complement the infrastructure renaissance in the state, stressing that her projects have surpassed any developmental benchmark used for projects evaluation. Her dogged fight for the rights of children led to the signing into law the Child Rights Law. The law, among other provisions, prohibits and criminalizes the denial of any child of school age the right to education. She was also instrumental to enacting the law giving women the rights to inheritance in Akwa Ibom State. Her husband, the governor, disclosed this much while talking to the Comfreys at the recently concluded African Women Leadership Organization in Uyo, Akwa Ibom State.
Through her effort, the House of Assembly recently passed what they call the Widow's Law, a widow's law to abolish the idea of the torture of widows. What she did, working with the House of Assembly, a law was passed in the state to protect the rights of widows. And of course, in many societies in Nigeria and in Africa, certain widows are not allowed to inherit properties of their late husbands. And then, of course, the girl child in many families will not be allowed to inherit the properties of their fathers. And so that law clearly spells out what you cannot do to any woman, whether it is a girl child or she's a widow. And I think it's a great initiative that you need to take back to your various countries. I think the First Lady has touched lives in a very exceptional way. She caters for the less privileged in the society. She even attempts through charity to build homes for widows. And through her today, we have signed a law which we call the Child Rights Protection Law, which has abolished stigmatization of children. It's a criminal offense for anybody in this state to stigmatize a child. In fact, it carries up to 10 years imprisonment. And then also she has worked very hard to stop the idea of abuse of children. And of course, trafficking in children. She has a home, she takes care of over 650 children that were brought from various countries, some from Gabon, some from Ghana, and some from Sao Tome and Principe. And these children were taken there and forced into prostitution.
The governor's wife instituted a yearly essay writing competition for pupils and students in public primary and secondary schools in the state to help hone the academic prowess of those who embraced the free and compulsory education policy of the administration. Her Excellency, who was represented by the Deputy Governor, Valerie Ebe, on the occasion of Children and Democracy Day celebrations, presented dummy checks, laptop, computers, and other prizes to deserving winners. These children, who are a testimony to the potency and success story of the free education policy, will, in August this year, be on their way to summer schools in China and in Ilorin, Southwest Nigeria, respectively. In a private luncheon at the government house, the governor's wife received them in person and presented them certificates.
Vivian Justin? Okay. Imo? Okay.
Imo was the first prize for junior. He's going to China.
To China?
Okay, yeah, he's going to China. Congratulations. And keep it up.
Okay.
Sierra is third prize junior.
Congrats. Third position.
The students were full of thankfulness to Mother Teresa for giving them a lifetime opportunity.
Well, I feel very glad and very happy because I didn't even expect that. Maybe I'm going to travel outside before. I've never dreamt of that. So I felt very glad and happy.
Now, are you in public school?
I want to thank Your Excellency, the wife of the Executive Governor of Akwa Ibom State, in the person of Her Excellency Mrs. Ekaette Akpabio and the husband, the Governor of Akwa Ibom State, that has set a platform like this for students of Akwa Ibom State to partake and also go a long way to empower them, because this going on an ICT store is a sort of empowerment to our youths. So I'm very happy and I thank them so much, and I say may God continue to bless them.
The words of thanks to Her Excellency is may God bless her because she has given us free and compulsory education for us to go free and compulsory education. Even though I'm very happy because my name is one of the essay writer and I am now an Akwa Ibomite student. Even though I am now, I can talk to the wife of the executive governor. I'm very proud.
When the free education was announced by the leadership tenor of Her Excellency, or His Excellency and his wife, my parents are not suffering from paying my school fees. and also buying my textbook from the market.
The essay writing competition was organized by Her Excellency's NGO, Family Life Enhancement Initiative, in a party later organized at the Government House complex to celebrate children in the state. Talents were put on display.
This is a friend's party. Everybody move your body. This is a friend's party.
Most of these children are being catered for by the governor's wife at the Divine Children's Home in Uyo. These immensely talented children are the same ones that biological parents abandoned in gutters, bushes and pit toilets and by the roadsides. They were picked up, cleaned, housed, fed and sent to school by the governor's wife. These and many more are some of the reasons she is a towering figure in the state and beyond.
Looking back on the memory of the dance we shared neath the stars above, for a moment all the world was right. How could I have known that you'd ever say goodbye? And now I'm glad I didn't know the way it all would end, the way it all would go. Our lives are better left to chance. I could have missed the pain, but I'd have had to miss the dance.
In similar fashion, the governor's wife, Mrs. Ekaette Unoma Akpabio, has equally changed the fortunes of many persons, especially the physically challenged and the widows. She holds meetings with the widows from time to time and sends representatives from her Family Life Enhancement Initiative NGO to meet and counsel the women and help them set up SMEs to earn a living. Across the three senatorial districts in the state, Her Excellency has built many houses and furnished them for the poorest of the poor widows. Whenever she moves out with her team to commission and hand over the properties, emotions run deep.
On behalf of Family Life Enhancement Initiative, I want to thank every one of you that found it in your heart to contribute to this noble project. May God bless you and may God replenish your pockets. And for our widow, may God bless you and may God bless whichever business you want to go into and bless the work of your hands. May God bless your children so that in your evening you live a better and happier life in Jesus' name. Amen. I commission this in the name of God the Father, amen, God the Son, amen, God the Holy Spirit.
I never hoped that God would visit me, but God now sent Her Excellency to bring me help and made me somebody. She took me from a tattered house and built me this one. God bless you and your family.
On behalf of Family Life Enhancement Initiative, I want to commission this room for our dear widow in the name of God the Father, the Son, amen, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I'm very happy for this house. The wife of the governor has built for me. I am overwhelmed.
In recognition of her efforts in giving meaning to this stratum of society and also giving women more cognitive role in the society and governance, the women and who is who in the polity of the state came together to celebrate Her Excellency's 42nd birthday. They prayed for God to give her many more years and wisdom to keep doing good. The women have this to say about Her Excellency.
I think Akwa Ibom State is really blessed to have Her Excellency Mrs. Ekaette Unoma Akpabio as a mother and as a first lady, because she has touched many lives. And it gives me great delight and pleasure to be associated with such a woman with wonderful and life-touching legacies. Behind our digital and dynamic governor, there is a wonderful, God-fearing, and a loving woman who cares for all. In 2007, the Family Life Enhancement Initiative, which is Her Excellency's pet project, was initiated. And through this project, she has touched many people. In fact, because of this project, Akwa Ibom State has become a prosperous and equitable society in which every woman, child, every person living with disability is now actively participated in all the programs.
Take her to a more higher position. You know what? And then I know that the extent she has gone, at least there should be one of us. Maybe the first, the next, whoever is going to be the next first lady in Akwa Ibom, or the governor of Akwa Ibom, the next governor of Akwa Ibom, the wife will come up to be even more than what she's doing.
A compassionate woman. A woman that gives all she has, a woman that doesn't discriminate, takes both the young, the old, whether she knows you or she doesn't know you, she takes everybody as herself.
She has done what God has asked her to do, and she will continue to do it to the very end. My prayer for her is that she will continue in the fervency and the depth even much more than what she has been.
Let us pray for her. Let us pray that such people, another encouragement I want to encourage us, women of Akwa Ibom, we need to have love. This woman loved me even when she does not know where I come from. That day she did not stay to want to listen to what I was saying. She did not care to know what happened. But she just embraced me. She just took me the way I was.
As the saying goes, behind every successful man, there is a woman. This much is playing out in Akwa Ibom State, where Her Excellency has mobilized women to support the present administration since its inception. In fact, during the campaigns, she was dubbed Chief Campaigner. This was in recognition of her unmatched ability as a grassroots mobilizer of women.
I call her Mpoto Akwa Ibom. She's a silent performer. This is a woman who has glamorized politics in Akwa Ibom as far as women are concerned. He has given Akwa Ibom women high profile identity. Before now, it wasn't like that. Women used to go one way while the first lady goes another. But she came in. I used to think I was a mobilizer until she appeared on the scene. She came in to give hope to Akwa Ibom women.
The women from the 31 local government areas of the state have always rallied around the governor's wife at major state events, adding color and beauty to such events. All these are happening right here in Akwa Ibom State.
Uncommon Transformation television series brings to you the latest information of the monumental achievements of the Governor Akpabio-led administration. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube to read the latest news, watch amazing videos, and listen to in-depth analyses and interviews with the men and women working hand-in-hand with stakeholders to make Akwa Ibom State better. You can also log on to our website, www.uncommontransformation.tv, for more information. Uncommon Transformation television series, bringing to you the right and current information when you need it.